Hey guys, are you worried about how to apply NEC online? Don't worry, I'm here to help you out how to apply NEC to get yourself registered in Nepal Engineering Council and get your license online. So let's start guys. I am Manas Shukla and you're watching your tech channel My Code Works. So first thing, you have to visit the Nepal NEC government site, right? NEC site, right? So as you can see here, I have already opened this government.np, and if you go downside, you can check out the link in order to register yourself to the platform, right? So I will just click it and let's see what's opening, right? And so I got this page basically, right? So this page is talking about something that welcome to online registration. It's there are lots of things are available here, and it's very important to check it out, all those things, because it will require all those things when you are going to apply for this, right? So first thing, they are saying that if your university is not recognized, check your universities are there or not. So check your universities is there or not. So basically what you can say, right, you just click on that link and you just find it your if you are from India, I mean you have completed your if you have completed your study in India, then you can just click India details. If you are going to other countries, you can just search that country, and after you just click on that particular country and you will get all the registered universities and that are recognized by NEC, right? So for example, for mine, and I will search it out. So as you can see here, LPU is also registered and Veltech also registered. As you can see here in BT Computer Science, Veltech Rangarajan also registered. So you can check it out. If it's not, then you can register it. You can make it recognized. That for that, it's a different process. We'll talk about later, not in this video. So for today in this video, we are going to learn how to apply NEC online, right? So each and every step I will explain, but I'm not going to fill that form, but how I filled, I will explain everything, and it's very easy. Trust me, it's very easy. It's not going to that much difficult. So whenever you get any doubt, whenever you get stuck at any point, please reach me out through comment section. I will try to help you out guys. So let me go back and just complete all the instruction, and I will tell you what are the things that you can see that if you do not find your university, your university may not be recognized by NEC. Please kindly visit NEC office. Like if your university is not there and you have to visit the NEC office and make it further, you know, what are the information to make it recognized, they will explain, right? And if university is there and you want to apply for it, right? So let's move down, right? And you can see here, fee for NEC general license registration, you can get it, right? So they are saying that if you have completed your bachelor in Nepal itself, then there you have to pay only 3,400 for Nepalese universities. If you have completed your degree from foreign countries like India and other countries, then you have to pay 4,400 rupees. So international universities including India also, so there you have to pay 4,400, and all the description are written here for how much they are charging, all those things, right? So you can check it out. And they are saying that if you are going to apply, before that you just first deposit this amount in Rashtriya Vanijya Bank. You can visit your nearest Rashtriya Vanijya Bank branch, and the account number should be this one, right? And the depositor name should be, it's very important that deposit name should be same whoever is applying for this, right? I will open it's a information, I mean they have released it, and they are saying that the person whoever filling the form, right, they should deposit their money, and the depositor name should be the same whoever applying for the NEC to get the license, and the voucher number and all those things, right? So it's very important that you should not say to someone that you be please deposit it on the behalf of me, and it's not going to work here. So you have to visit the bank and you have to fill those things, and you have to write your own name. So you can not make online payment here. They are also making note down, right? So online payment such as IPS or transfer or bank transfer is not valid here. So you can understand it. And now let's move to the next thing, the requirement, main important thing basically. So what is main required things are here, like, so before applying to anything, we need some document, required document. So what are the documents that we need? Even though you will get it on the same thing, you will get it on the gate of NEC office, but they made it online, so you can get it from here itself. So first thing they are saying that you have to get your marksheet of SC equivalent. If you have completed 10th class from foreign country, that's also you need to get the equivalent first, right? And second thing, character certificates of 10th class, transcript of 10 plus 2 or equivalent if you have completed your degree, or if you have completed high plus 2 in foreign country, then you need to get the equivalent. If in Nepal, then simply you can post, you should have a HSB transcript and all those things, right? So character certificate from plus 2, you can get it from your college, and or equivalent, something like that, okay? And transcript. So transcript basically, it's saying that bachelor's degree, okay? So marksheet and character certificate of 10th as well as 12th class. Now coming to bachelor, there you need a bachelor's degree certificate, right? Character certificate first they are saying character certificate, and after that a provisional certificate of bachelor degree issued by the university, and next equivalent certificate. So if you have completed your degree from foreign country, not in Nepal, even class 10, then you need to get the equivalent of all those levels, right? SC, 10 plus 2 and bachelor, and license certificate of 2 registered engineer issued by NEC. So basically this is important. So without 2 reference, you cannot apply for it. So better you ask someone who know, and they will give the reference, and you can easily upload it, right? So you need 2 reference of registered people that are registered to NEC, right? And citizenship, it's like upload notarized only, not the original one, and passport size photo for identity card, okay? So these are the things, and they are saying again, these documents should be notarized only, not the original one, and you just get the copy of all these documents, collect and bring, go to some lawyer or a notary firm, and they will make it notary, right? Now after getting notary, you just scan all the document and save somewhere in your folder, right? In your phone or laptop. And after that, while filling this form, we will need those things, right? So better you save somewhere in a folder. And now after doing all those things, you can make it online, right? After filling this form, you can send all those documents to them directly by a post, or you can visit the NEC office and you can submit it there itself. So let's start, guys. I will tell you the procedure. Let me click on apply now, and it will open the registration page. So basically, as you can see here, one form is opened here. Basically, it's saying that first name, last middle name, and last name. You just specify your gender and all those things. It's very simple. And one tool I can say that it's saying that please press space to convert your name in Nepali, right? But sometimes it's not going to show the same exact name in Hindi or Nepali, right? If you put space or press space here. So for that, what I'm going to suggest you, better you use Unicode converter, right? You can write your name somewhere in this, like that only, right? So you just simply write in English and you will get the Nepali version, and just copy it and paste it here, like right? If I just copy it and I will paste it here, I will get it, right? So if I paste it here, okay, it's not I'm not able to paste it, but if you are getting some problem here, I will tell also how to make it, you know. Don't worry, you will just write your name, you will get it basically here. So you just write your name and you will space, if you say, right, you will get like this only, right? But while filling the form, you will need some somewhere in the field, you need some, you know, you can simply paste it right here. They have disabled it, but anyway, you can write your name, it will get converted easily. So here you have to write the email, right? Some email should be there, and you have to agree the terms and conditions, whatever they have specified, and submit it. So after doing this thing, after filling these things, you will get a mail, okay? You just get a mail to the email that you specified. So the mail should be containing something like this, okay? I will just open it and I will explain it through it only, right? I'm not going to fill the form again, because it's terms and conditions are specified that I cannot submit the false information here, so I'm not going to fill it again. So I will just say how the things are happening, right? How things are working. So when you register, when you click on register or sign up, then you will get some mail something like this. And in that mail, it's saying that everything. So dear, whatever name you have written and all those things submitting, we require to provide further information because you have step one, you have completed in like information, first name and email and all those things. So it's completed step one, your information completed. Now they are they have given all the steps, right? What are the steps they are going to require in order to complete this online procedure, right? So it's very easy, right? Just you follow them and usually you will get all the forms and just fill it, right? So you have completed your information and now login information, you are here. So verify first and after that they will again open a login page. That login page should be like this. Okay, login page should be like this. When you click on verify, you will get some page something like this. And here you have to write the that same email that you have wrote and password, whatever password you get in your mail, because in your mail only I think you will get the password. And after that what you can do, right? And let's open this email. And here everything they have explained. So after that, step three is personal address information. Now third is academic details. So fourth is fifth is like training and employment and other things are there, right? So one by one step we have to complete and we have to fill those forms, right? And again they will get some button submit in next step. So whenever you complete one step, you will get next step directly, and in that you will get all those things, all the forms that need to fill, right? So talking about the personal for address information, I will just open it, right? Let me close it, and again I will open it first. So when you fill the form, you will get something like this. After filling all those form, I will explain it, right? After filling all the details and submitting it to NEC, you will get something like this. And there it will showing like your application is pending. You will get notified by email whenever they approve the status. It around 2 to 3 months it will take, and they will approve it, and you will get a email notification that your application is approved, and you can collect it from there itself, from office, right? So you will get something like this, and your name should be written here, and application number you will get, and address whatever applied, I mean whatever you have given the address, email, phone number, and education up to the latest one. Like if you completed your master, then it will show master, right? So these are the first page. I mean if I go next, then you will get something like this, personal information. So personal information, basically what they are collecting it, you will get all these forms while following those steps, right? So don't worry, it's not like that much stuff. If you stuck at any points, please reach me out through comment section. I will try to help you out as possible as I can, right? So these are the things that they needs from you. So you can fill it out, first name, last name, and all those things, DOB, AD, and BS, as well as father's name, mother's name, grandfather, right? So these are the things they will need from you as a personal information. Now coming to as I have told you that they need your personal address information. Then at the time, okay, so let me just go back to the same thing and I will explain it. Okay, so as you can see here, contact information as a address and temporary address and permanent address. So there will be some button where we can make the same permanent as a temporary address. So if you click on checkbox, it will reflect back the same thing, temporary address also. So in that you just specify your whole detail like zone, district, VDC, ward number, toll, village, cell phone, and all the things, right? Whatever you have, just fill it. And also one important thing, wherever star hashtag is there, right? It's a required field, you have to fill it anyhow, right? So other things are like you can skip it, but hashtag fields are very important and it's required data, so you have to fill it. So let's move to next thing, that is reference information. As I already told that we need to register engineers, right, information and their certificate details, right? So you just get it from your connection and you will get it definitely. There are lots of people are there. So there you have to specify their name, right, address and council number they will get once they register to NEC, and email they used while filling this form, and phone number, as well as category, on which category they have registered, right? So once they will get a mail when they you use their details, and they have to verify your request, because if they are not verifying, it means that you don't know them. So better request them that you please verify the mail that they got. And as you can see, it's verified. Email reference, email verification is verified, and you can see it all the details. Now talking about the academic qualification, I will just open that steps. As you can see here, in personal address information is completed. You will get it. It's not that much difficult. You will get all the steps. I mean, it's very easy and smooth procedure how to fill these things. So if you follow these things, you will get the form and you just fill it, right? And while filling these things, if you get stuck, please reach me out. I will help you out. Academic details. In talking about the academic details, and I will just go back and explain you. Okay, academic details. Yeah. So this is the academic details that you have to upload in the while filling the application for NEC. So you need SLC, as I already told that, character certificate as well as transcript. So transcript and character certificate needed to upload here. So all the notarized document you have to get notarized, then only you can upload it, and then only they will accept it. So as you can see here, I uploaded. And intermediate, talking about the 10 plus 2 transcript you have to upload. Sometimes the transcript is like more than one page, right? At that time, what you can do, you can just click to you just scan the two pages and make it one single PDF and upload it here. So they are also allowing to upload the PDF also, but mostly they are allowing to upload PNG only, I mean image format. So character you have to upload, and they will also ask the percentage, either it's a CGP or percentage, you have to write it here. And bachelor's, if you have completed, right? I mean, while filling that, definitely you have completed. So bachelor detail also, transcript, provisional, and character. So transcript also PDF, you can upload it PDF, and provisional and character, these are the PNG format. And talking about the personal documents, then they are asking citizenship, front and back. You can upload if you have taken in the same page, you can upload the same two in the same both field. If front and back you have, then you can upload front and back, and number and issue date, on which date you have issued, all those things, right? So this is the details that we need, and let's move to next thing. As I told that you have to visit the Rashtriya Vanijya Bank, and you have to deposit the amount, and there where we need all those things, right? You have to scan the receipt, right? Copy of receipt, and scan. After scanning, like you have to enter the amount, how much amount you have deposited, and name of the depositor, voucher number. It's not that much necessary, but if you get from bank, then definitely you just write it and deposited date, on which date you have deposited, and here you have to upload the voucher, right? So after moving to, after uploading these things, there you have to upload a scan copy of thumbprint, both right and left hand thumbprint. You have to put it in a white paper and scan it and upload it here as a PNG. And uploaded scan copy of signature. So write on do signature on some white paper and scan it and upload it as a PNG. So these are the things that we need, and while filling the form, right? It's not that much tough. So again, I'm saying that if you get stuck on any point, right, please reach me out through the comment section. I will try to help you out. One more thing, if you have completed your degree from Indian universities, please get the equivalent certificate from TUCDC first. So for that, how to apply NEC, I have already made a video. You just check it out. I will provide the link in the description box, and also I will show the I button. You will get there, you can also check it out. So let me move to the next thing. After filling this form, right, after filling this form, you will get something like this. So there you will it will say that you have applied for this, and what you can do, like you will get the application receipt number and on which date you have applied. So basically, after submitting those things, you have to get the printout first, right? Okay, I will just open that this thing, right? So personal detail and payment detail, all those things. In personal and payment details, like personal, that if you have completed your training also, you can upload it here. If not, then please skip it, no issues. Academic details, I already told that you have to upload the 10 and 12 and remaining thing, as well as personal detail, payment details. Here you have to upload your citizenship and that voucher and receipt and review and submit. So review means all over the things that you have wrote, you just review it whether all are correct. If it's wrong, then you can edit it and submit it. After submitting, right, after submitting, what you will get? After submitting, you will get something like this. Thank you for your registration. You have received your application. Please submit the hard copy of application form along with the hard copies of the documents and original copy of bank voucher. So please bring your original copy of bank voucher that you got while depositing the money in bank, and all the notarized copies of all the certificates you have to bring, as well as including the form that you will get a form. There is a button, print the form, right? And you will get a form in PDF that will contain all the details, right? You have to print it, you have to take it, print out, as well as the two printout of that two registered engineers certificate and one photo. This much documents required. You have to visit the NEC office in Kathmandu, Naxal, and you just submit them, right? They will take it and collect it. After submitting, around 2 to 3 months they will take, 2 to 3 months they will take and approve your status, and application will be approved. And after that, you can visit at any time and collect your engineering license certificate from there itself. So these are the whole, you know, procedure to register in NEC online, right? So if you get stuck any point, again I'm saying, if you get stuck any point, I will try to help you out. Please reach me through comment section, because I have applied it, right? So I know what are the things needed. Yeah, sometimes you can use compressor tools, right? UniCAD for Unicode, because we need there, we need to fill the things in sometime in Nepali. So you can use this thing and compressor to compress the file if it's increases. I mean, it's more than that required file size. So you can use these things. I have already opened. So these are the things that we need while filling this form, right? And for scanning the document, you can use any scanner. So these are the things that the whole procedure I have explained. If you get, please let me out. Let me check. I mean, let me, you know how, what, at what point you got stuck. I will help you out. So I hope you have enjoyed this video and like this video. Please do share, subscribe my YouTube channel, and I will make this kind of video again and again. And thanks for watching this video. Don't forget to subscribe my channel.